Hello everyone. Last day in my class, I was discussing about human settlement, what is human settlement, then types of human settlement, etc. So today I will start different types of rural settlement. Okay. So the rural settlement classified into four categories. One is clustered settlement, second one is semi-clustered settlement, third one is hamlet settlements, and fourth is dispersed settlement. So firstly, I will discuss about clustered settlements. So what are clustered settlements in rural areas? The clustered rural settlement is a compact or closely built up area of houses. That means the area is compact or covered with compact or closely build up of buildings or houses. In this type of village, the general living area is distinct and separated from the surrounding farms or agricultural land, pastures, and etc. The closely built up area and its intervening streets present some recognizable pattern. For example, geometric shapes like rectangular pattern or like radial, circular, etc. Such settlements are generally found in the fertile alluvial soil areas. For example, in India, in the northeastern states or the fertile alluvial plain areas, sometimes sometimes people live in the compact village for security or defense reason. That means in compact area the security is high, such as Bundelkhand region or central India and in Nagaland. In Rajasthan, scarcity of water has necessitate compact settlement for maximum utilization of available water resource. So this is the full description of cluster settlement. So second one is semi-cluster. Semi-cluster may result from the tendency of clustering in a restricted area of dispersed settlement. More often such a pattern may also result from segregation of a large compact village. In this case, one or more section of the village society choose or is forced to live a little away from the main cluster or the village. Such settlements are widespread in the state Gujarat and some parts of Rajasthan. Next type is hamlet settlement, the third point. Sometimes settlement is fragmented into the several units physically separated from the each other bearing common name. These units are locally called panna, para, polli, dhani, etc. in various parts of the country. The segmentation of a large village is often motivated by social and ethnic factors. Such villages are more frequently found in the middle and lower Ganga plain. For example, Chhattisgarh and lower valley of the Himalayas. In the hamlet settlements, the number of houses is too small. There are only 12 houses or maximum 25 houses are there. Next is dispersed settlement. Dispersed or isolated settlement pattern in India appears in the form of the isolated huts or hamlets, a few huts in the remote jungles or in a small hills. Basically, the dispersed settlement we found in the hill areas where the terrain is racked terrain. And also some physical factors or physical barriers are there. For example, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh and some portion of Kerala have this type of settlement. So these are the main four types of rural settlement. One is clustered, next is semi-clustered, third is hamlet, and fourth is dispersed. So write down for 5 marks this question. Discuss the 4 types of rural settlements.